Subramanian Swamy, please.
Mr. Deputy Chairman, recently the Narendra Modi government has placed most of the files regarding the assassination of Mahatma Gandhi in the National Archives. And I've had a chance to go through it, and I think it's very important for us because a lot of scurrilous comments are being made outside the outside here. Even parliamentarians are making these remarks, and the Supreme Court has to pull them up and give them a stern warning. So I think this time the House discussed it, and I can, for the benefit of the House, point out three basic facts which have come out by my reading of the archival records.
It is already allowed.
He can't stand up on a point of order on a point
of
order.
It is already allowed.
Chairman, sit down.
It is already permitted by Honorable Chairman.
Yeah. Please. Yeah. Not please. Right. You're no one to question the chair.
No, no.
He's questioning the chair.
First, you listen to what he says.
Mr. Chairman.
First, you listen to what he says.
Mr. Chairman.
No, please. No, please.
Doesn't matter. He will have to give me tomorrow, next week.
No, please, it's allowed.
Sit down.
No, see, Anand Sarmaji, unless you hear what he says, how can you object? No, that's okay. See, unless you hear what he says, how can you object? Let me hear. No, you didn't say anything. He only said Supreme Court has made some observation. He didn't say what it is.
Man.
Okay. Ma'am. Please.
Mr. Deputy Chairman, for example, the records show.
Don't take any name.
I'm not taking any name except Mahatma Gandhi.
Yeah.
I will not take any other Gandhi name.
Okay, go ahead.
I want to say that the records show that Mahatma Gandhi was not subjected to any postmortem. As a consequence, there was a dispute in the trial of the number of bullets fired. The newspaper said 4 bullets, the prosecution said 3 bullets,
Time over. Now it is time for question hour. Subramanian Swamy, please.
Mr. Deputy Chairman, recently